The island of Sodor is a very special place indeed. There are lots of different forms of transportation. Road, bus, tractor, and railway. Among many others, of course, but railway is the most popular. You can see lots of engines hard at work, like Thomas, who always cheers everyone up. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the island of Sodor.
Young Resourceful Wisdom. One day, the Fat Controller was at Tidman's sheds when Edward bustled up. Hello, sir, boomed Edward.
Hello, Edward,
boomed the Fat Controller. Edward, you must go to the shunting yard and work with Wisdom. You must take some trucks, delivering them and picking up cargo across the island and through the towns and taking them to the yards.
Yes, sir. I've always wanted to work with Wisdom. I'd heard she's very resourceful, and she has heard the same about you.
I expect that you will both work very well together.
Indeed, sir, said Edward. Get going at once.
Edward was ready to go, and he bustled away.
Edward was puffing along to the shunting yard. He couldn't wait to meet Wisdom.
Wisdom was upset. She was all hooked up to the trucks and ready to go.
Hello, Wisdom. I'm Edward. It's nice to meet you.
I know you're Edward. I'm Wisdom. Pleased to meet you, too.
Come on, Edward, she said impatiently. Let's go.
All your freight cars have been loaded, said the workman.
Couple up, said Edward.
You can take those half back there, said Wisdom. I'll take my own track.
No, said Edward. We shall go directly and promptly there together.
But the train is heavy, said Wisdom. It would be better if we worked on our own.
And she puffed away with her half of the freight cars.
Edward decided it was best not to argue and just backed down onto his trucks. And he started away too, to the first junction.
Edward and Wisdom arrived at the first junction.
Okay, so what are we doing? Are we going to work together, puffed Edward, or solitary and on our own?
I want to work by myself, said Wisdom. The train is heavy. I think it would be best if we split in half like so.
Fine then, said Edward. I guess I'm working by myself too.
Even though I'm faster, he said.
Hastily, Wisdom was shocked as she watched Edward puff away. She puffed on her own too.
Edward was steaming along. These trucks are getting heavier, he said, as he puffed past the first station.
The trucks were holding back.
Wisdom was seeming to have no trouble at all. She puffed happily by herself.
Edward whistled to Wisdom, but Wisdom ignored him.
Have to go on, she panted.
Edward arrived to the hill.
He puffed his way up, but he struggled and strained. Oh, my axles, he said as he slipped back down.
He was just puffing for another try when...
Oh,
stop holding back, said Edward. Hold back, cried the trucks. And they pulled Edward downward again.
This made Edward very cross. He went up for a third try, and this time it worked, but his trucks wouldn't go through.
Wisdom puffed through the towns. She was having a splendid run, but her trucks were being troublesome, biffing and banging her. Her driver had opened the regulator.
Have you heard, said one of the townsmen.
That engine is Wisdom.
I've heard she is very resourceful.
Thank you, said Wisdom. I just wish Edward could see the same.
Wisdom whistled loudly.
Come along, you cars, she smiled.
The cars didn't want to come along.
Hold back, hold back.
Edward was waiting happily at Knapford Station. Wisdom bustled up alongside him.
Do you still need any help? Asked Edward.
No, thank you, said Wisdom. How about you?
No, I'm fine, said Edward, snootily.
It was out of character for Edward to be snooty. Mario saw this. Fine, said Wisdom. If you don't need help, then I'll just be on my way because I am a resourceful engine and I can work just as well on my own. Chase after her, said Mario. You're right, puffed Edward. Woo-hoo! Wisdom steamed out of the station and round the bend. Hello, Wisdom. Mind the gate, cried Philip. But Wisdom ignored Philip. And she raced past the gate just as Elizabeth rolled up. How rude, said Elizabeth. But Wisdom carried on. Wisdom was going harder and harder. Her driver and fireman jumped clear. And they tumbled down the bank as Wisdom went right off the rails. Bust my buffers, cried Wisdom. We're stuck and in danger and I'm dented. She'd fallen off the mountain. It was a terrible, terrible mess. Edward had arrived to the station where he was delivering his cars. I'm first, he said, and all done, I told Wisdom. Oh no, said one of the workmen. Wisdom has fallen off of a cliff. Edward, you must hurry to her rescue. All right. Hurry, Edward! Edward brought Rocky to the rescue and the Fat Controller. Wisdom, boomed the Fat Controller, you have severely endangered your driver and fireman. And, sir, said Wisdom quietly. They're dead, she whispered. The Fat Controller sighed. I don't know what I'm going to do. But at least you're all right, Wisdom, said Edward. Please, Edward, I'm sorry. Can you help me, please? Yes, said Edward. I'd be happy to help you. Come along, said Wisdom. So finally, after they'd finished their work, Edward and Wisdom happily returned home. The Fat Controller greeted them warmly. I am regretting you to inform you that at Wisdom's driver and fireman, stuttered the Fat Controller, have passed on. All the engines sighed. At least you are okay, Wisdom, said Dominic. I was worried when I heard about it. Thank you, Dominic, said Wisdom. It's good to know to have a friend. I'm your friend, said Edward. Yes, you are. Maybe new ideas are just as good as old ones, said Edward. You're right, smiled Wisdom. Have you ever had trouble working with another engine or with a friend, which resulted in trouble? Once, both my friends Dominic and Sasha were having a bit of an issue working together. Dominic and Sasha thought it'd be fun to compete to see who could work the fastest and collect the most passengers and deliver them the quickest. Dominic and Sasha were going very fast and they continuously made silly errors and mistakes, which caused trouble for Dominic. Wisdom and Edward were having trouble working together. Wisdom didn't enjoy working with Edward, which resulted in her harming herself and her crew. Very dangerous ways. But luckily, Edward and Wisdom decided that new ideas should be heard just as well as old ones should. And we should always listen to each other. See you next time.
Cheeky one,
James,
his fame but lots of fun,
Percy,
pulls a man.